Mr. Speaker and members of this chamber, good afternoon. House Bill 255, despite what you've been hearing from the other side, is actually incredibly simple. For every single person in this chamber today, I'm guessing this is not your first job, which means at some point, every one of you experienced what work actually means for the very first time. This bill is aimed at giving our young folks today the exact same experience for themselves, the chance to work, learn, grow, just like you did. You probably remember what you were like as a teenager, and maybe you didn't have the same attitude and appreciation for work as you do today. Today, with the benefit of hindsight, you probably understood some of those lessons you learned at your very first job a little better. How important the responsibility was, what lessons you brought to your next job, and one after that, maybe even the real value of a dollar and what it means when it's earned, not given. For everyone on the other side of this bill, you're standing in the way of these lessons. That's the basic truth about this bill. A generation ago, more than half of teenagers aged 16 through 19 had a job. Today, it's closer to 1 in 3. What lessons are being learned instead of on social media or in a video game, or by putting off those lessons about personal responsibility? With our state's workforce participation at 46 lowest in the nation, and the largest group being teenagers between the ages of 17 and 25 year olds, what are you trying to protect from our kids from? What damage are you actually doing to them instead? Right now, Kentucky's laws are arbitrary and restrictive on when and how much teens can work, especially compared to other states and federal law. Places like Texas and Wisconsin have been letting teens work for more flexible hours, and guess what? Their high school graduation rates are among the highest in the nation. In Kentucky, our current statutes and regulations unnecessarily restrict the number of hours teenagers can work, often preventing them from seizing opportunities that could help them save for college, learn new skills, and prepare for their futures. Our legislation simply seeks to remove these barriers, aligning state regulations with federal standards, therefore allowing our teenagers the same opportunity as their peers in nearly half the states in our union. That's what this bill actually is. I want to address some of the Governor Beshear's told the media when our bill passed out of committee, when he opposed the measure and wondered what kind of message it sends. The message it sends is that work has value, and teenagers who want to work or need to work to help their family or on the family farm or save for college or save big purchases shouldn't have the same Kentucky government standing in the way. Actually, young men and women who go on to have part-time jobs in high school make 20% more than their peers that did not. Governor Beshear said these protections exist for a reason, and I want to assure the governor that federal and state child labor laws will not be undone by this bill, no matter what his misunderstanding of the law might be. Perhaps he forgot to read the bill. In fact, we might want to familiarize ourselves with our own Commonwealth Career Center, which has a page specific dedicated to promoting youth programs, including summer youth employment, school year employment, pre-apprenticeship programs, internships, and job shadowing on job training opportunities, some for children as young as 14. The message that sends is that Kentucky supports work, and I think it's an important message. Studies show that providing youth with meaningful work opportunities can significantly reduce youth crime rates and contribute to a more stable and prosperous society. And just think about this. If you are a gifted athlete here in the state of Kentucky, football does limit you to 5 hours practice a day, but does not include weightlifting or conditioning. All other sports have unlimited time they can practice. And you can play high school sports with a GPA of 0.6. So where are we putting our emphasis? Moreover, at this time, when our nation faces a labor crisis, enabling more teens to enter the workforce addresses is not just an education or social issue, but an economic imperative. In short, this bill is a win-win. Mr. Speaker, if I have no question, I move for passage of the bill.